गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ सेट्स। व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सेट्स, टेल मी वंस। नंबर 1 सिंगल टर्न सेट, नंबर 2 एम्प्टी सेट, नंबर 3 व्हाट इज द थर्ड वन, फाइनाइट सेट, फोर्थ वन इनफाइनाइट सेट, फिफ्थ वन व्हाट इज द फिफ्थ वन, इक्वल सेट्स, सिक्स्थ वन इक्विवेलेंट सेट्स, सेवंथ वन यूनिवर्सल सेट, एइथ वन डिसजॉइंट सेट्स, नाइंथ वन पावर सेट्स, दे आर द मेनली दे आर मेन टाइप ऑफ सेट्स। सो आउट ऑफ दैट वन सिंगल टर्न सेट कंप्लीटेड। व्हाट इज सिंगल टर्न सेट, सेट कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ वन एंड ओनली वन एलिमेंट इज नोन एज सिंगल टर्न सेट। सेट कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ वन एंड ओनली वन एलिमेंट इज नोन एज सिंगल टर्न सेट। सिंगल मींस वन एलिमेंट। What is the example? Set of even prime numbers. Set of even prime numbers. Then, what is the next one? Empty set. What is empty? No elements. So, a set which does not contain any elements is known as null set or empty set or void set. Null set is represented by symbol you know, phi. And I told you two more points. And a null set is a subset of every set. Empty set is a subset of every set. What are the examples for empty set? Natural numbers less than 1. Empty set. Negative natural numbers. Empty set. If no answer is there, it is known as empty set. So those two topics completed yesterday. Third one is, so null set is a subset of every set. Null set is a subset of every set. Every set is a subset of itself. Two important points. Null set is a, this is null set you know. Null set is a subset of every set. Null set is a subset of every set. Every set is a subset of itself. Every set is a subset of itself. Okay na? So that is about empty set. Third one is, so today we continue the type of sets. Third one is finite set. Finite set. What is finite set? A set which contains countable number of elements. Define finite set. A set which contains countable number of elements is known as finite set. So what is finite set? A set which contains, a set which contains countable number of elements, countable number of elements, countable number of elements, a set which contains countable number of elements, a set which contains countable number of elements is known as finite set. So what is finite set? A set which contains countable number of elements is known as finite set. A set which contains countable number of elements is known as finite set. So what is the definition of finite set? A set which contains countable number of elements is known as finite set. Example. So many examples are there in your textbook. Go through the examples clearly. And one exercise is there. In that exercise, we decide it is finite set or infinite set. Suppose, example, A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. How many elements are there? N of A equal to 4. Number of elements equal to 4. Number of elements equal to 4. It is finite set. So remember, if we are able to count how many elements are there, it is known as countable set. I mean finite set. So here 4 elements are there. Cardinal number is 4. What is 4? Cardinal number. Number of elements in a given set. So how many elements are there? 4 elements are there. It is known as finite set. So a set which contains countable number of elements is known as finite set. Let us take one example. Here four elements are there. Four elements are there. So it is finite set. Suppose natural numbers, uncountable number of elements are there. It is infinite set. Whole numbers, infinite set. Rational numbers, infinite set. Even numbers, infinite set. Multiples of five. It is infinite set. We'll see one more example. This is first example number 2. Factors of 12. Countable or uncountable. So factors are 12. What are the factors of 12? 1 is a factor of 12. 2 is a factor of 12. 3 is a factor of 12. 4 is a factor of 12. 6 is a factor of 12. 12 itself is a factor of 12. So how many elements are there? There are 6 elements. So n of a equal to 6. So it is countable, so finite set. So what is finite set? A set which contains countable number of elements. What is n of a? Cardinal number. Number of elements in a given set is known as cardinal number. So that is n of a equal to 4 here. It is finite set. Here factors are 12, n of a equal to 6, so it is finite set. So that is about finite set. Next about infinite set. Fourth one, infinite set. Later we will see in exercises about types of sets briefly. It is finite set or infinite set. We will see it later. Fourth one is infinite set. Infinite set. What is infinite set? A set which contains uncountable number of elements. A set which contains uncountable number of elements. Uncountable number of elements. So is known as infinite set. A set which contains uncountable number of elements is known as infinite set. We are unable to count how many elements are there. It is known as infinite set. So what is infinite set? Uncountable number of elements. Suppose example 1, multiples of 5 table. What are the multiples of 5? 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. So many are there. Uncountable. It is infinite set. Then second one. Suppose natural numbers. N equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. It is infinite set. It is also infinite set. Third one. Whole numbers equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. It is also infinite set. We are unable to count how many elements are there. It is infinite set. So what is infinite set? A set which contains uncountable number of elements is known as infinite set. Example number 1. Simple examples we will see. And we discuss about finite set and infinite set later in exercises. So simple example, multiples of 5, natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, everyone is infinite set. Uncountable number of elements are there. It is known as infinite set. Next one, no? Equal sets. Equal sets. Equal sets. Number 5. Equal sets. So define equal sets. Two sets are said to be equal if they have same elements and the same number of elements. Two sets are said to be equal if they have same elements and the same number of elements. So first point, two sets are said to be sets are said to be equal if they have number one same elements number one elements should be same number two same number of elements means n of a equal to n of b cardinal number should be same it is the second condition then we say a equal to b then a and b are equal okay na so when two sets are said to be equal number one same elements number two same number of elements then only a and b are equal same elements same number of elements then only a and b are equal example a equal to 1 2 3 4 b equal to 2 3 1 4 so what are the elements here how many elements here 4 how many elements here 4 condition number 2 okay so same number of elements cardinal number should be same cardinal number should be same number 2 even though they are in different order first one 1 2 3 4 second one 2 3 1 4 so both are same so a equal to b then we say a and b are equal that is equal sets so two sets are said to be equal if they have number one same elements number two same number of elements n of a equal to n of b then a and b are equal this is equal sets next one equivalent sets equivalent sets equivalent sets sixth one equivalent sets equivalent sets two sets are said to be equivalent if they have same number of elements two sets are said to be equivalent if they have same number of elements so two sets are said to be equivalent if they have same number of elements then second point symbol for equivalent is so this is the symbol for equivalent just like double arrow symbol for equivalent is that one just like double arrow so a is equivalent to b can be written as can be written as a equivalent symbol b a is equivalent to b can be written as a equivalent to b so what is the condition n of a equal to n of b n of a equal to n of b then both are said to be equivalent then example A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. B equal to 4, 5, 6, 7. How many elements here? 4. How many elements here? 4. So here 4 elements. Or we can write 5, 6, 7, 8, right? Better. Here 4 elements, there 4 elements. So both are equivalent but not equal. A is equivalent to B. But not equal. A is equal. equivalent to B. First set contains four elements. Second set contains four elements. So n of A equal to 4, n of B equal to 4. They are equivalent but not equal. Fifth one, all equal sets. All equal sets are equivalent. All equal sets are equivalent, but converse need not be true. Converse need not be true. Converse need not be true. So all equal sets are equivalent, but converse need not be true. See this example. This is only equivalent but not equal. So what is equivalent sets? Two sets are said to be equivalent if they have same number of elements. If they have same number of elements, two sets are said to be equivalent if they have same number of elements. Same number of elements. N of A equal to N of B. Then symbol for equivalent. This is the symbol for equivalent. A is equivalent to B, can be written as A equivalent symbol B. Then let us take one example. A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. B equal to 5, 6, 7, 8. Here, N of A equal to 4. 4 elements are there in A. 4 elements are there in B. Both are equivalent but not equal. See this example. This is only equivalent but not equal. So, all equal sets are equivalent but converse need not be true. All equal sets are equivalent but converse need not be true. This is about equivalent sets. So today what is completed? Number one, finite set. What is finite set? A set which contains countable number of elements is known as finite set. Next, infinite set. A set which contains uncountable number of elements is known as infinite set. Next, what is completed? Equal sets. Two sets are said to be equal if they have same elements and same number of elements. Same elements and same number of elements. Then equivalent sets. Two sets are said to be equivalent if they have same number of elements. N of A equal to N of B. What is N of A? Cardinal number. What is N of B? Cardinal number. Both should have same elements, then only they are same number of elements, then only they are said to be equivalent. So A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 elements are there. B equal to 5, 6, 7, 8, 4 elements are there. All equal sets are equivalent, but converse need not be true. Okay, now this example is only equivalent but not equal. Okay, now next. In the next class, we finish the remaining part of the introduction. Then we will start the exercise 2.1. Okay, now. So, next class, we discuss about the remaining types of sets and some Venn diagrams also, if possible. We try to finish the introduction in the next class. Thank you, students.